one, which is our monetary system. And that is what, you know, kind of we've come up with. And we said, so this is something that's been inspired by a startup that I follow very closely. It's called Holochain. It's not a startup, it's one of the most, you know, well-respected companies or ecosystems in this particular space. It's been designed by someone called Arthur Brock, who's the founder of Holochain, where he basically said, look, there are layers to it. The first is the most fungible thing, which is you buy a product or a service, and the value creation in that space is defined by scarcity, because it is limitation of what we are doing. There's limited another person's who restores the vitality in a certain ecosystem. Now we can start thinking of our ecosystems in this manner, where every single thing that one person gives out is consumed by another person, so there is no real waste that's happening. The vitality keeps getting restored in the flow of that. And identity and connectivity, which is today there is this entire flow value of big meeting. I'm sharing this information. Tomorrow, this ecosystem can partner with a whole set of sustainability initiatives across the world and say, guys, we've received this, everybody's in this room. Can add that, restore the information you receive from this space, and give it back to another ecosystem and say, listen, this can work for you. You can sort of think through ideas that you've received from here, go back to your homes and kind of create different ways of working. So there is connectivity between ecosystems, and the fact is that today we've got rules for corporations which are based on privacy, data control, data protection, etc., which kind of prevents this because it's still functioning in the space of competition, where I need to be better than the other person. My market value is X billion dollars, and hence I'm the most powerful company in the world. But guess what? Really, who's the winner in that space? Is the ecosystem thriving? Are we really making the most of all the value that we are creating in any given space? Value can be amplified. And that is the beauty of using innovative techniques of designing currencies in new ways. And that's what crypto currencies are sort of used for. Because today, while we're sitting on the layer of the first innovation, which is anti-tax security, which I'll come to later, the real innovation will come when we can move away from the weak. You know, we don't look at money as just, or as a currency as just money in the pocket, but how is it that we're sort of sharing our value systems with one
another? Absolutely. You said it.
So essentially, coming back to what is money. Money is basically that value, that entire ecosystem, the monetary system which has been created to find a way in which we can engage with one another. The issue is when I go to buy an apple at say, you know, Nature's Park, it doesn't tell me what happened in the process of that apple coming to me. How many pesticides were used? How much nature was, you know, disrupted in the fact of use of chemical fertilizers? How much? There's a lot of information which is hidden from me. So the only metrics that I have for my decision making are, okay, 100 rupees or 80 rupees. I'll go for the 80 rupees because on the surface of it looks very good. Maybe I would be happy to pay 100 rupees if I knew why was it 100 rupees, what was the reason behind it. Today we do have certifications on organic, etc. So those are forms of currencies. Maybe that's sort of one layer of development. Coming to clothes, who made my clothes? The fashion revolution that's underway. Who was sacrificed? How were they incentivized correctly? Were they treated well? Were the conditions in which they made my clothes good for them? Someone like me would have value for that. So I would not, you know, mind. But the issue is, everything today is hidden under the guise of price. And so while H&M may be giving me the cheapest clothes and fast fashion, little do I know that they're actually creating the biggest damage to the environment with all the landfills. So it's really, I know it because I've heard about it in this space, but did I know about it before? No. And my decisions were just based on what's revealed to me. And the big shift in the technology part of it is when we use blockchain or distributed ledger to reveal all this information across supply chain, decision making based on availability of information becomes a choice that comes back to the power, back to us. And it is through our conscious choices that we can actually bring a shift in our ecosystem and the vibrancy of the way we function as a human collective. So this is basically something I studied from a new development, a new type of cooperation, which which is like one step away from private limited or public limited kind of companies or LLCs, which is B Corps, which is benefit corporations. It's a structure that I did some work for someone and I studied it and I really liked it because they have four parameters that they sort of assess impact, which is governance, community, humans, and environment. And this is what our ecosystem comprises of. So we are going to start looking at just everything in terms of value being measured as price, which is how much do we give back to the investor, not about value creation that happens across all these spaces. And we're going to just keep awarding the ability, like our incentive structures today are based on rewarding people who are capable of extracting from the ecosystem as opposed to giving back and bettering our ecosystem. We will be removing from our ecosystem as a country, we will be doing it disservice. And so we will be not enhancing its value and not increasing the value that comes to our ecosystem if we just stick to national currency. It's a very different system. It's like functioning in a stone age. I personally do not agree with it. And yeah, that's it.